Where's your gratitude towards your church leader? Where's your gratitude? I'm done. Towards the people in your house. They're not doing it the way you want it done, but they're there.
Amen.
See, Pastor, I keep telling these women.
Jesus Christ.
He's not on.
That's right.
Stop complaining about what he's doing wrong.
Yeah.
That's it.
He's still in the house.
Yeah.
Most of the brothers got to step in the things they're talking. Y'all got all kinds of deals in front, but he's still there.
Yeah.
I knew I come to church complaining about him. Shut up. I said, Lord, I thank you that he's sleeping because he works all night. You mad because he can't make it to McDonald's to get a dollar cup of coffee? He's been working all night. Shut up. When was the last time? I'm getting in trouble with your pastor. I gotta stop. When was the last time you thank God for your children?
Come on now. Come on.
Of gratitude.
Yes.
Your mother. I had this talk with my sister last night. Our mother's passed. When was the last time you thank God for the person who made sure you're still alive?
All right.
See, he's so ungrateful. All we want to do is talk about what they didn't do and what they don't have. Now all of a sudden, pastor, we get to the point where we're going to start fighting our parents.
Jesus.
God help me.
Wow.
What kind of fool you got to be?
Come on.
Somebody knocked at you. Who could have killed you and let you die?
Yes.
Brought you to the point where you can function on your own.
Yes.
And you are grateful.
Wow.
Well, you know she spanked me. She got to kill you.
Go ahead.
If spanking was going to kill her, I'd be dead.
Yeah.
But my mother spanked me on a daily basis. I was not one of them modern children. I got in trouble all the time. My mother would grab anything. She just be back like this. Or whatever she grabbed, that's what she was coming forward with. That's why I'm so strong today. I got...
Go ahead.
Stand up, please. God, I love you, man. When was the last time? Am I helping you here? When was the last time you prayed for your pastor? When was the last time you prayed for the people who prayed for him? The pastor's aid committee, his mother, the deacons, when's the last time you went before God in a serious way? I'm not talking about now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I'm talking about getting in there and warring and fighting that devil who's trying to stop from praying. And pray on through the resistance. Till you can tap into God and you can feel his presence as you pray for your pastor. Last time you labored in prayer. When the last time you put an offering aside? My pastor laboring. When I got off of drugs, Bishop, we had a budget in the house, you know, and my budget was $50 a month. That was my spending money. Of course, I had no clothes or no shoes or nothing, so I was using that to buy shoes and clothes. And the Lord spoke to me, said, honor sacrificial giving. I'm giving you a testimony. And out of that $50, every week, I took $25 and put it in Bishop Curry's hand. Sacrifice. Couldn't buy no shoes then. Today I can't have space to put my shoes. I got to put them on the garage. I had on some shoes one day. One of the first pairs I bought, he walked past me and kicked the shoes. That was Sunday. Monday he had a pair. They don't understand this. You don't understand this. God help me. You sacrificial. When was the last time you sold a sacrifice into your pastor? When was the last time you said, I'm not going to buy this dress? I'm not going to take Junior to McDonald's. I'm going to give you a testimony. Do you mind? 3 Sundays ago, I called for a sacrificial steed. One of our members not here today. She called me. She told me on the phone. She had $55 in the pocket to pay her light bill. All she had. The Holy Ghost said to her, so a sacrifice for something. For love, she said, I remember saying that, but she heard that, but not for me. She sold the $55. Watch this. Her life shut off for 3 days. Sacrifice. She stored in obedience and didn't have lights for 3 days. Her father came and cut her light. But I didn't even know she was married. She stored for her husband who was in prison. They had just given him 9 years on his sentence because he got in trouble. They had a review for him and they canceled the review because he got in trouble. She sowed the seed that Sunday. Monday they opened up the review without nobody knowing why.
Wow.
Do you know that on the 1st of December he'll be home? God, I need to be who believe God. It's a miracle, Why? Because somebody decided to make a sacrifice. Some people need to give them a God happening. She was in the house with all her child for 3 days, but God honored it.
Yes.
Now they took 9 years off his sentence and said, we can give you time, sir. Go!
Yes.
Somebody just clap your hands and give God praise. Now stop being a prayer hater. You will get the same response from God. If I was able to use praise and abundance, then praise comes down. When praise comes down, anything can happen. It's a practice of prayer. Give me praise for your situation, for your circumstance. When's the last time you did something good for God?
Glory, glory.
I didn't know I was leading up to this, but I know you go out to church and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
But I need those who believe.
Yes, sir.
I need a sacrifice from you this morning. Yeah. This is something you didn't plan to give.
Ms. Vickers'
daughter had a federal charge. I mean, four. They told her, the federal governor, they told her, you have no chance. But she came to church and heard the word, how you gonna bend if you don't confront it? Her mother told her to give up on it. But she was in church every Sunday hearing the word of faith. She said, no, my apostle said to fight, I'm gonna fight. When they got to court, they said it's gonna be a 3-month trial. She sold a seed of $100. Y'all remember that? It's an anointing on $100 seed. Y'all remember that? She put a post in the chair. Sold the seed that Sunday. Went to court that Monday. Tuesday, the case was dismissed. That's what you're praying about right now. That's what you're praying about right now. Somebody has a faith to believe God. Oh! Ah! I'm trying to go home, Holy Ghost. Oh, shut up. Oh! Shut up. You didn't expect this, I didn't expect to do this. If you never trusted God and then sacrificed, that cost you something. God, I'm talking to the 5 people I'm talking to, I hope you hear me. That cost you something, deep soul, something you can't afford. And I declare to you, what you sow it for. For whatsoever man sow it, there's someone had a mask here. For whatsoever man sow it. If you believe that, say amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, say amen.
Amen.
I have, thank God for this, I have a prosperity anointing on my life. Wherever I go, it's a great increase in giving. And that's not something that I earned or prayed for. God's placed that on me. So I'm asking everybody to come up here with a sacrifice. In your hands, a thanksgiving offering unto the Lord. Your sacrifice may not be my sacrifice, but everybody in this sanctuary should put something in this basket. And listen to the preacher, do not play with God in the night. Bring a sacrifice. If you all you have is a dollar, that's your sacrifice. If all you have is $100, that's your sacrifice. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I see blessed people trying to, who hear from the Lord and want to do something different. It's got to be a sacrifice. It's got to be something that you didn't plan on giving. It's got to be something that you can't afford to give. I like this. I like to see people moving at the voice of God. Only God knows. Jesus said, the lady who put the mind in, she gave more than all those people to all the simple.